Hello everyone, welcome in the third part of incompatibilities in prescription. I am Mrs. Sandhya Lanke, faculty Sri Jain Vidya Prasarak Mandal's Rasikla Lem Dharival College of Pharmacy Pune. This is the concluding part of this chapter in which we will discuss about definition of therapeutic incompatibility. We will discuss reasons of therapeutic incompatibility. And after watching this video, you will be able to identify therapeutic type of incompatibility in prescription. What is therapeutic incompatibility? It is the change in the therapeutic effect of one drug by either prior or simultaneous administration of another drug. It is also called as drug interaction. So, when the intensity or nature of action of drug is different from that intended by prescriber, then such effects are called as therapeutic incompatibility. For example, if a physician wants to cure the elevated body temperature, but apart from that, if any side effect is also observed, then it is nothing but the therapeutic incompatibility. And why this will be occur? It will be just because of simultaneous administration of two drugs together. It is very simple. So there are different reasons of causing therapeutic incompatibility. The first one is error in dosage, then wrong dose or dosage form, synergism and antagonism, contraindications, and drug interactions. So let us discuss one by one all the reasons with an example. The first one is error in dosage. Now many therapeutic incompatibilities result from error in writing or interpreting the prescription order. The most serious type of dosage error in dispensing is overdose of medication. So, it becomes the duty of pharmacist to check the prescription before dispensing it. For example, the prescription containing codeine phosphate with a quantity of 0.5 gram, and if you have been asked to send such 10 powders with the direction 1 powder to be taken at bedtime. So, what is the duty of pharmacist? He have to identify the type of incompatibility. So in this prescription there is an unintentional incompatibility, and this is an example of overdose of medication, because the intention of physician may be to prescribe 5 milligram, and yet he have prescribed 500 milligram, nothing but 0.5 gram of codeine phosphate in the prescription. So what will be the remedy? The prescription should be referred back to the prescriber for necessary correction. The second reason is wrong dose or dosage form. There are so many drugs which have quite similar names, and there is always a danger of dispensing the wrong drug. For example, prednisone and prednisolone. These are having similar pronunciation. Second is digoxin and digitoxin. Then sometimes many drugs are available in different dosage form, and hence if the dosage form is not clearly mentioned on the prescription, it becomes necessary to clarify by the pharmacist from the prescriber, because so many drugs are there which are available either in tablet or in solution or in suspension or in drop form. So depending upon the patient condition, the prescriber may have written the dosage form or the medicine. So accordingly, the pharmacist should send the prescription back to the patient and get clarified from the prescriber. The next reason is synergism and antagonism. So we have already discussed the definition of synergistic effect and antagonistic effect in posology. So what is the result of synergism? When two drugs are prescribed together, they tend to increase the activity of each other. So that is known as synergism. So synergism is usually intentional because the prescriber has prescribed the drugs together in order to increase the activity of drug. For example, combination of aspirin and paracetamol increases the analgesic activity. Then combination of penicillin and streptomycin increases the antibacterial activity. The correlated one is antagonism. When two drugs are prescribed together, they tend to decrease the activity of each other. It is known as antagonism. So the prescription, such type of prescription should be referred back to the prescriber for necessary correction. For example, here in the prescription, aspirin and probenecid both are used in the treatment of gout. So here the two anti-gout agents, when they are prescribed together, there is neutralization effect, because in this case acetylsalicylic acid and probenecid used in the treatment of gout. However, the combination of these leads to neutralization. So what will be the remedy? The prescription should be referred back to the prescriber for necessary correction. The next one is contraindicated drugs. There are so many drugs which may be contraindicated in particular disease or for particular patient who is allergic to it. For example, corticosteroids are contraindicated in patients having peptic ulcer. Second, the penicillin and sulfur containing drugs are contraindicated in patients who are allergic to it. Then the vasoconstrictors are contraindicated in hypertensive patients. Now why this is so? Because in hypertension, already the blood pressure in the vessels is going to be increased. And if vasoconstrictors are given, what will happen? The vessels will constrict and suddenly again there will be trigger in the blood pressure that may produce the fatal effects. So we have to take care in such cases and we have to follow the instructions given by the physicians. Then the next one is drug interaction. Example, now there are various type of drug interaction, drug-drug interaction, drug-food interaction. So the effect of one drug is getting changed by prior or simultaneous administration of another drug. The drug interaction can be corrected by proper adjustment of dose. For example, here tetracycline hydrochloride with a direction for pharmacist make capsule and the label is take 10 capsule every 6 hours with milk. So this is an example of drug-food interaction. Here the tetracycline is inactivated by calcium which is present in the milk. So tetracycline capsule should not be taken with milk. In this prescription, the therapeutic incompatibility is there and that too unintentional incompatibility. So the remedy is avoid administration of tetracycline with milk to prevent the formation of insoluble complex. So the prescription may be referred back to the physician to change the direction. So this is about therapeutic incompatibility. Thank you for watching this video.